Welcome back. What is that worth? How fast is the wind blowing? In order to make a good wind call, you need two things: wind speed and wind direction. We've talked about wind direction in previous videos. Today, let's talk about wind speed in multiple contexts. I was answering questions the other day about learning to read the wind flags at F-class matches, and I pointed out that to read a wind flag effectively, you have to calibrate the flag behavior to the actual wind speed. You see, wind flags come in a variety of fabric weights. Even after they're made, bleaching out in the sun for a couple of years makes them a little lighter and more sensitive to the wind. Likewise, a little dew or sprinkle of rain makes them heavier and less responsive. If you travel much, you're going to have to figure out what the wind speed is, either through measuring the wind speed and comparing it to the flag behavior, or by shooting and learning experimentally what the wind flag behavior is worth. Both ways work, but knowing the correlation between the flag behavior and absolute wind velocity is a big confidence builder as the wind picks up. There is nothing like trying to learn what's that worth in the middle of a relay when the winds are dancing around at 5 to 8 miles per hour. Likewise, knowing the behavior of the vegetation, dust, water, and other natural elements around you, including the sound of the wind, is a plus to your wind calling, especially if you shoot on some of the ranges that I do. At many of those, the flags are either buried in the edge of the trees or mounted to poles so large that the flag isn't in view until the wind is really big. I've found the best way to calibrate to a wind flag is to stand near the base of it and use a wind meter, like this Kestrel unit, to read the wind speed. The downside to turbine-style wind meters is that they are incredibly wind direction sensitive. If the wind direction is flipping and flopping about, you're likely to get a lesser understanding of the total wind velocity picture. We can always mount the Kestrel on the wind vane that they sell, but it's a bit cumbersome and really draws some attention. Alternately, you can use an omnidirectional wind meter like this one. I picked this up the other day off of Amazon. It's made by Alpa River. Never mind, I can't pronounce it, and is really inexpensive. So I had my reservations about its performance. By the way, I'm not saying that company name again. I'm calling it the Cup Unit from now on. I'll leave a link to it in the description. To ensure that this was going to read the wind speeds needed for shooting, I first had to determine if it compared to the Kestrel, a known good unit. I started by checking the minimum startup and minimum indicating speeds. This was done by walking up and down a hallway while holding both meters out in front of me, like this. I worked the speed up from about 8/10 of a mile per hour to about 3 miles per hour. This was done indoors to make certain that the only air movement was me walking. The Cup unit has a minimum startup speed of 1.3 miles per hour, and the Kestrel beats that, starting at as little as 0.9 mile per hour. As I accelerated, I found that the two meters matched quite well at the low end, so I went outside to get some bigger numbers. As luck would have it, I experienced 3 days of what would be excellent low development weather, as there wasn't a breath of air anywhere. I mean, it was deader than a prairie dog that encountered a VMAX at high speed. So I went back and read the instructions while I was waiting for the wind gods to bless me with a breeze. This thing is made somewhere overseas based on the English in these instructions. There's a warning in here to use only as directed with a variety of disclaimers. Whoever wrote these must also be writing the labels on over-the-counter drugs. Who would have thought that a wind meter would be for external use only? Okay, I made that last part up. What I did learn is that this thing has two buttons on it. The I button turns it on and off. The M button changes which units it reads in. I will note that it includes a compass on the top. Why would it have a compass? Well, I have no idea. It seems odd to me. So after 3 days of waiting, the Seattle office of the National Weather Service flipped on the wintertime switch and issued a gale warning for today. Winds are expected to be 25, gusting to 35 knots. For those of you using miles per hour, that's about 28 to 40 miles per hour. But it's going to build up after dark, so I had to settle for whatever was available after work. The Cup unit has the ability to mount on a tripod, which I did just to make it easier to film. It works just the same, handheld. I found a somewhat open area without too many witnesses at the local dog park. The wind was gusting and switching rapidly, giving me an opportunity to assess the responsiveness of the units in comparison to each other. The Cup unit is far more responsive and goes slightly higher in each gust. It also slows more than the Kestrel in the lows. This suggests that the Kestrel turbine has quite a bit more inertia to overcome. After a few minutes in this location, I decided to move to get a slightly better background. I shot a short clip, after which a good solid gust came through while I was fiddling with a camera. The Kestrel was solidly in my pocket at the time, but the cup unit caught 26 miles per hour at the maximum, and that persisted for about 3 seconds. Who wants to come out and shoot here? This would be a good day to find out if you're looking upwind or not. Which brings me to an observation. The wind speed on the cup unit only includes tenths of a mile per hour up to 19.9 miles per hour, then reads whole numbers above that. Not ideal for getting a perfect wind speed for a shot, but I think it'll suffice for the intended purpose. I've only had this cup unit for a few days, and I don't know what the reliability or durability of it is. But at slightly less than $30, I really don't care. There are similar units with other company names on them that are 10 times the price, but I'm not sure they are actually made any differently. At those prices, we're coming quite close to being able to use an ultrasonic sensor to measure wind speeds. The advantage to having a cheap wind meter like this cup unit is that you can leave one in your car, and anytime you feel like training your wind spidey senses, give the wind speed a guess and turn the unit on. You can learn to read the wind off of grass, trees, water, or the feel of the air movement on your skin, calibrating yourself the same way you would when calibrating the flags. All experience in wind reading is cumulative, whether on the range or sitting in a parking lot. I'm glad I have this little guy. It'll make me a better wind reader over time. I'll be using it to show a few considerations in wind calling over the next few months, as the weather allows. To repeat what I started with, in order to make that perfectly centered shot, whether in competition or hunting, you need to understand the wind speed. Learning how to read the natural indicators or wind flags around you is critical to success in that endeavor. Until next time, go outside and watch the wind, and I'll see you in the next video.